In today's video, I'll be talking about ephedrine and amphetamines. Starting with ephedrine, it is a sympathomimetic, so it mimics the activity of the sympathetic system. It has mixed actions and stimulates alpha and beta receptors. This action is weaker than adrenaline. It shows tachyphylaxis, which is a rapidly diminishing response to successive doses of a drug. This means that we're increasing the doses of a drug, but the response to those increased doses is decreasing. Coming to its pharmacological actions, in the cardiovascular system, the heart contractions are increased, heart rate is increased, systolic and diastolic blood pressure is increased, and the cardiac output is increased. In the respiratory system, bronchodilation takes place, which is a beta 2 effect, and decongestion takes place, which is due to vasoconstriction, which is an alpha 1 effect. Ephedrine stimulates the central nervous system and produces alertness, euphoria, and insomnia. Coming to its therapeutic uses, it is not used as much anymore, but it was used in bronchial asthma, nasal decongestion, and spinal anesthesia. Its side effects in the central nervous system include insomnia, restlessness, irritability, and anxiety. In the cardiovascular system, it causes tachycardia, palpitations, hypertension, and precipitation of angina pectoris. In the urinary bladder, it causes urine retention. Now coming to amphetamines, they're also sympathomimetics, so they mimic the activity of the sympathetic system. They're indirectly acting and they act more powerfully on the central nervous system. Their pharmacological actions on the central nervous system include euphoria, alertness, increased ability to concentrate, decreased sleepiness, decreased appetite, and mild analgesic action. In the respiratory system, there's an increase in respiratory rate and depth. In the cardiovascular system, there's an increase in contractility of blood vessels, increase in heart rate, increase in blood pressure, and reflex bradycardia. Amphetamines are used for depression, ADHD, which is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. In this, the person is hyperkinetic, so cannot stay still and has a shorter attention span. In narcolepsy, which is increased sleepiness, and they're used as an anorexiant, as they suppress appetite. Amphetamines are abused by athletes for performance enhancement. In the central nervous system, the side effects are insomnia, restlessness, and convulsions in toxic doses. And in the cardiovascular system, the side effects are tachycardia, palpitations, hypertension, and they produce tolerance and addiction.